You want to do some kind of comparison. You want to do further analysis to better understand your findings. What do you have to do? One way is to go to explore. When you go to explore, you can go to project maps. You click on the project map and then you give it a name, right? Any name that you want. You can say themes for, maybe you want to compare themes, right? Themes for research question one. And then you click on OK. So when you see this space, you can right click here, right? And go to add project items and go to code. And then we are looking for themes for research question one. So we're gonna choose maybe two of the themes to do the comparison. And then you click on OK. So you have the two themes here, this one and that one, right? So you can right click on one of the themes and you go to show associated items. And then anything that is connected to this theme will be displayed here, right? So what we are interested in, we just want to know the cases that are connected to this theme. So you click on this arrow and then you can double click on the cases. So P1 is connected to this theme, P3 is connected to this theme, right? And then we also want to see the files that are connected. So obviously to be P1 file and P3, right? So these are the files and these are the cases, right? So the cases are just the container that houses all the information about participant, including the theme, transcripts, and demographic information. So you do the same thing for the second one. Let me push this one to the side. Right click on the second theme, you go to show associated items. There are two items here, the cases. You can also look into the files that are connected. Another thing that you want to know is that, okay, it looks like this theme and that theme here, they don't have anything in common. It also gives you an idea that, okay, I think this theme, which is putting extra effort, has nothing, no connection with having less time for family. You can also right click on the case and click on show associated item, and then go to attribute values and go to the demographic information. So you can see that this participant is 37, this participant is female, and this is the work experience and African American. So you can bring that information here. You can do the same thing for P3. Right click, show associated item, go to this place. This one, you go here, you click on the case classification folder, the arrow there, and double click on the demographic information. And then you can do the same thing for the other participant connected to the other connected to the theme. We go to attribute values, click here, you click on this arrow, you double click, you go here, the person is 30 and Asian. We go to the next one, right click, show associated item, go to attribute values, you go to the age area. You click on the years of experience and ethnicity. Now that you are done, you can go to layout, and that will help you to rearrange the information in a very nice way for you so that you see what is going on. So it looks like the only thing that this have in common is the gender. P1 is female and P4 is also female. So this one gives you an idea about the connection between this and that theme. Sometimes it's going to be interesting if we delete all this information and focus on, let's say you are talking about this theme, right? You can show who is connected to the theme. You can see that two participants are connected. This can be a very good visual representation if you are talking about your theme. So this is one way of doing a comparison. Another way is to go to explore. Let me close this one. To go to explore and go to diagrams. And then we're going to first compare files. Let's compare participant one and maybe four. You can compare two items at the same time. You cannot compare more than two. You click on OK. And this is what you're going to see. The one that is compared is has been highlighted for you. So we are comparing P1 and P4. They have something in common. They have research question two and one. They have some connection, right? But I think that's the only thing that they have in common. You can explore and then take things out. So if you take the cases coding out, this is what you're going to see. If you take the codes coding out, this is what you're going to see. So, you know, if it makes sense to you, you can present that information to your audience. If it doesn't make sense or it's not really adding value to the findings, you don't have to present this information, but you can explore and see what you're going to get, right? So this is how you're going to compare files. Let's try to compare. So we are going to now compare, let me go here, quotes. Let's compare maybe, let's go to compare these two themes and see what we're going to get. It looks like they don't have anything in common, right? Interesting. This one is showing the files, participant transcript, and also the cases that are connected to this one. And this one is showing the same thing. If you click on parents, this gives you information about which research question is this theme under. The only thing that they have in common is that they are under the first research question. They are all causes of burnout. If you click on the children too, this one also gives you information about codes that are under the themes. So if you check the children, this is what you're going to see. You can uncheck, and then this is what you're going to see. You can uncheck this one. If you want to export, you right-click and export this diagram, and you'll be able to show. Another one that we can do is to compare. Let's go to explore and compare cases. Let's compare P3 and P1. What do they have in common? Oh, they have a lot in common. So P3 and P1, they have this theme in common. They are all connected to having less time for family. They are connected to the first research question. They are connected to the theme called having time with family. Oh, having less time with family and having time with family. They are all connected to that. And this is connected to the second research question. So you can just explore and see whether it's making sense. You can check attributes. Attributes are the values of the variables. So you can see here that this participant is a male, Caucasian, 70 years of age and 35 years of experience, right? So this one is also going to be good if you want to get participant background. So you can even uncheck this one and it can show who they are if you want to display that. You can also take out the files that have been coded and just show the attributes, that's the variables and the values connected to them. You can bring back the codes if you want to. You can uncheck attributes. This is how you can do the comparison. So the next one that is another way of comparing is to go to metrics coding query. Click on metrics coding query and we click on set items and go to classification. Click here and go to gender and then you can check male and female. Click on OK. You have that information here. Click on the plus sign, select items. And then we want to go to the codes and see all the themes for the research question one and see how they are connected to the agenda and run query. So as you can see here, for females, there are two significant information connected to this theme. There's one here. For males, there's zero. Zero means that the males are not connected to this theme. One means they are connected and one significant information was extracted. If you want to know the significant information that are connected, you can double click and it will take you to the source. Now you know the source from P1 and from P5, and all of them are females. And also you can click on charts to see the visual representation. if it makes sense to you, you can present this information. As you can see here, it gives you the number of significant information connected to a specific theme and also the gender group. This one, when you export it, you cannot turn it as you have it here, right? But there are simple charts that you can show, like this one. You can also right-click and export. So here you can see here that four counts, four significant information connected to this theme from males. So this is how you can also do the comparison. You want to compare males to females, right? So another way of doing a comparison, let me close this one, is to create a framework matrix. You can go to create and click on framework matrix and you give it a name, any name that you want. So this one, I can say that maybe for RQ1, right, for research question one. And I go to role and then select items and then maybe I'll select all participants. And here, attributes, there are variables that are connected to the participant. So I can select that and go to this plus. And then maybe I want to see their gender, their age, and maybe their work experience, right? And click on OK and go to column. And then you can select the themes that are connected to the first research question. And then you click on OK and click on OK here. It will create a table that the columns will be the themes and also the rows will be each of the participants that you have. So now we can right click here and go to undock so that we can see the whole table. So as you can see here, we have the table here. We have each participant. This is P4. The age and their demographic information are there, right? So you can easily see who they are. You can go to framework metrics tab here and click on auto summarize. This will make sure that you pull up all the information that you have coded, right? All the significant information will be pulled up for you to see. So as you can see here, the system has pulled up all the significant information. So you see that here P1, the demographics are here. You can easily compare this one to P2, looking at this theme and also the significant information that was extracted. So you can use this table to do further analysis, compare and contrast the significant information you have extracted that are connected to a specific theme from each of the participants. And this one, you can export it by right-clicking on it and then click on Export Framework Metrics, and then you will get it from Excel. What if you want to create a framework similar to this, but in this case, you want to group them based on gender? What do you have to do? Let me show you how to do it. You can go to cases, and what we're going to do is that we're going to group them based on gender, right? So in order to have a reference for that, we can double click here. When you double click on participant ID, it will give you all the information about participant. If you want to know how to develop this participant ID, my videos on YouTube will be very helpful for you, right? I'll try to link my video there so that you see. So we want to group them into the gender. So what we have to do is go to cases, and right click here, new case, and then we have male. Aggregate coding from children. And then we can right click again and then have females. Aggregate coding from children. And then what we have to do is to drag and drop. So P1 is, we look at here, P1 is a female. P2 is male. P3 is male, P4 is female, P5 is a female. Now that you have done grouping them, you go back to create framework matrix, and this one, gender and themes for research question question two this time. And we go to roles and we click here, and then we can check female and male, right? And the next one, we don't put anything here. We go to the next one, column, and click on select. And we are focusing on research question two. We select all of them, all of the teams, and click on OK, and click on OK here. Okay, so you see how the system has grouped the significant information into two groups that we have. So if you want to make it larger, you right click here and click on undock so that you can see it a bigger way. We have two rows, right? Male and female. And there's no information here. If you want to bring all the information that have been coded, you click on this tab, which is framework metrics, and click on auto summarize. And then you'll be able to get that information and then do the comparison if you want to. So you see how the system has pulled up all the codes, all the significant information connected to the males and all the significant information connected to the females. You can do the comparison. You can see that all the males are not connected to the first three themes. They are only connected to the last two, right? Females are connected to all the teams except the fourth team. So you see how you can make some kind of comparison here. So this is how you can do some comparison, and you can also export it by right-clicking on it and go to export framework metrics so that you'll be able to export and maybe do further analysis. So this is what I have for you. You can explore and compare. You can do the same thing for work experience or age. If you have them in groups, you can group them based on age and then do their framework metrics. So this is what I have for you. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comment section. I'll be happy to address them for you. Thank you so much for your time.